some of the other sources that the Rosen Piranha has available are really pretty neat, pretty spectacular. As you can see, it looks like a very clean face and very minimal controls, and not a lot of ability to plug in other sources, but they do a very good job of hiding those other inputs. Right down here, we've got an 1/8-inch mini jack that we can do headphone to headphone or full-blown AV in with an adapter, so we can plug in any audio source into that, just headphone to headphone. Or if you pull this cover, this exposes an SD card, micro SD, and a USB slot where we can plug in either an iPod or any USB device, USB stick, what have you. We also, down here, have another USB off of the back side of the radio that allows us to have another dedicated USB source, or again, an iPod, or what have you. So the way that we're gonna, I'll show you the USB operation. Let's go ahead and plug a stick in there. And now you see that we've got the USB source lit up as an option. We go out to USB, it goes ahead and loads, and it'll function just like any USB, mass storage device. It'll give you album art if it's available on the device, if it's in the directory. Has all of our ID3 tagging, everything that we'd normally want to have, as well as all of our controls up top, including repeat, random play, search, etc. We can also go out to our list where we can browse the contents of this stick. So we can go to any other directory, have direct access, and go ahead and choose that song. Go ahead and turn it up. And as it's reading all of the data off of that USB drive, it'll go ahead and bring up all of the song data, the album art, and everything if it's available in that directory. So, pretty neat. So you can use this, again, just plug in a USB stick, whether it's on the face or on the rear, and be able to have, 1,000 songs on your stick at any time you want and have direct access to it. So the other thing that you can do, if we go ahead and unplug that, we can then go ahead and plug in our iPod. And whether we use it in the front or the rear USB, makes no difference. We'll go ahead, it recognizes our Rosen, and now lights up our iPod as another source. So we go out to iPod, does exactly the same thing that it did on our USB stick, goes ahead and starts playing, and as it's loading all of our data, there we go. We've got full album art, all the data, everything that we'd normally need, as well as track control, random play, everything. There we go, there's track up. Another track up. Well, we're in random play now. It's pretty amazing. So very quick, very nice and easy to work with all of our data, etc. As well as having, and this is very much a new thing with Rosen. It's very nice, full access in just about as fast as you can press the button. Access to anything on the iPod just literally as fast as you can press it. There we go. So iPod's a very cool source, and you can either leave this plugged into the USB on the face, or show you here real quickly. We get exactly the same playback capability if we plug that into the other USB jack that's on the back of the deck as well. So we could, for instance, even have our iPod plugged into the cable on the back, come up and plug in our USB stick on our jack on the front, and now we have both iPod and USB and the ability to go back and forth between them. Pretty neat. Very flexible, very easy to control number of different sources on the Rosen Piranha.